Basic information again and again. So last time we covered what? We covered trigonometric T ratios, basic T ratios, and heights and distances. Today we are going to take up identities. Okay, so that's what we are now going to do. So again, if you see, this is the deleted portion. So you know, in trigonometry, how much is the trigonometric score or weightage in the board? You know already. So let me just select a pointer first. Yeah. So these are eliminated, or these are not there anymore. Heights and distance, no elimination. Trigonometric identities, trigonometric ratios of complementary angles are not there. Okay. So hence we will not be dealing with them. Okay. Now, this is again to revisit the pattern of the paper, so that, you know, now we are doing it multiple number of times. That doesn't mean that it is going to be, you know, you never know, board can come up with a new pattern also, but mostly unlikely. But you know, till anything comes out or any changes are made, we will assume that this is what is going to be for the board exams now. So what are the what is the pattern again? So you know that there are 80 marks paper. This is 80 marks paper for the regular people. For the autonomous people, we have, you know, have they declared from the school side? I have to just confirm with the school as well. But I think last time they had a 50 marker paper, but it will not be a 50 marker. It will be either 70 or 80, mostly 80. So we'll have to just confirm. But anyways, the type of questions are going to be similar. Now, so there are 16 one marker, one mark questions. So again, if I have to, you know, start. Right, one mark question. How many? So you have to be very, very thorough. 16. And there are how many? 4 case studies of 4 marks each. So we have 4. You can assume that also. So let's say 16 one marker again, one marks in 4 case studies. There will be 5 questions. You'll have to do 4 out of 5. Right. So this is the pattern. Now, this is 16. So hence this is also 16. So total is 32. So part A is 32 marks. Part B will obviously be of how much? 48 marks, right? So 48 marks ka breakup is what? So there are very short answer type questions of 2 marks. So if you see 2 marks, 6 questions. 6 questions. So 6 questions into 2 marks is equal to 12 marks. 7 questions of 3 marks, so is equal to 21 marks, and 3 question of 5 marks is 15. So this is nothing but 48. So this is the breakup. You will get some internal options in few of the questions, right? But you can't skip any particular topic. In one particular topic itself, there will be 2 questions given. Okay, so this was the structure. Now let's come to identities. So today we are going to deal with identities, and we'll be solving all the previous year questions, at least the previous year, the sample paper of this year, and 2018-19. So you get fair enough idea of what type of questions are being asked. So hence, in grade 10, we have only 3 types of identities, which are called Pythagorean identities as well. So sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So this is 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta, and 1 plus cot square is cosecant. So CSE is nothing but cosecant square theta. Okay, so proofs you all know, I think. Yep. So if you have to prove it, what do you need to do? You just need to, you know, take a triangle. And yeah, so basically, okay, let me do it here as well. So now that I have some free space here, I've just deliberately kept it. So we are going to first proof, and then we'll be talking of some different, some various manifestation of the same identities. Okay, so this is P, perpendicular B and hypotenuse H. This is theta. Let this triangle be ABC. Okay, and clearly sine square theta. What is sine theta here? So if you see, sine theta is equal to P by H, and cos theta is equal to B by H. So square both sides, or basically sine square theta plus cos square theta will be equal to p square upon h square plus b square upon h square is equal to p square plus b square upon h square. Right? So hence this will be nothing but p square plus b square by Pythagoras theorem is h square upon h square, hence 1. So this is the most basic identity you'd have learned, and though they will not ask for the proof, but yeah, you should also have this in mind. Now, what important about this identity will be different manifestations. What do I mean? So sine square theta plus, and this is the basis of the questions which will be there. So sine square cos theta plus cos square theta is 1, which can be very easily written as sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Now, all these forms and manifestations must be clear in your head. This is where lots of questions on board have been formulated. So we'll solve few of them anyways, and I'll show you how this is so relevant. So hence, this can be very well written as, So this can be written as sine theta into sine theta is equal to 1 minus cos theta into 1 plus cos theta. And this is very, very important manifestation. So what is this? So you can write, you can always write sine theta upon 1 minus cos theta is equal to 1 plus cos theta upon sine theta. This is very, very important, right? Way of writing it. So this use of this is so many times. So you remember this. Also, the same thing can be written as cos square theta is equal to 1 minus sine square theta. Okay. And hence, you can see this is nothing but cos. This is nothing but cos theta upon 1 minus sine theta is equal to 1 plus sine theta upon cos theta. Right. So these are different types of manifestation. So, you know, the questions will be there where you'll have to replace them like that. So please remember, right? So this is how you can treat one identity is same as so many. And the other important point is wherever you are seeing this one. Okay. So one can be written as sine square theta plus cos square theta. There will be many places where you have to apply this. Yeah, I request all the students to join on time, because what happens is the moderator gets distracted, right? So hence, all students should be joining on time, right? If you're struggling, you can immediately reach out to any of the representatives in the groups, but coming on time will be very, very crucial. Okay, so please do that. Do not wait for anything. Just join in before 3:30. So we have now put the timings also such that the link is active around 3:20. So hence join on time always. Okay. So coming back to, so this is clear. So you have to keep this in mind. So not only, this particular identity is important. The way it has to be written is also important. So one, this brings these three together. So keep that in mind. Now, next one is again very important. Again, it is called a Pythagorean identity, trigonometric identity, 1 plus tan square theta secant square theta. So there will not be much of a problem to prove it. So you can do again. So let us say this is A, B, C, and this is theta. This is 90 degrees. This is base. This is hypotenuse. This is perpendicular. So 1 plus tan square theta, 1 plus tan square theta is equal to 1 plus tan theta is opposite by adjacent, and then there is a square. So this is 1 plus p square upon b square, which is b square plus p square upon b square. And b square plus p square is nothing but h square by b square, which is nothing but secant square theta. So this is the proof. Okay, so this is the proof. Now, again, manifestations are important, not only the identity, but how to write the identities in multiple ways. So 1 plus tan square theta can be written as secant square theta. And here is the game. The game is like this. So you can write secant square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. And now you must be aware that this can be written as secant theta minus tan theta into secant theta plus tan theta equals 1. That means secant theta minus tan theta is reciprocal of secant theta plus tan theta and vice versa. Understood? So secant theta minus tan theta, important, right? Secant theta minus tan theta can be expressed like this. Alternatively, secant theta plus tan theta, reciprocal is 1 upon secant theta minus tan theta. So just by changing the sign of tan, right, you can get the reciprocal. So many a times this will be applicable again. So keep this in mind. Another way of representing this would be chat. Where did the chat thing go? Okay, so yeah, another way of another way of representing this would be this. What you can write this as secant square theta minus 1 is equal to tan square theta. Okay, so this is going to be important. Now, secant square theta minus 1 is tan square theta. Again, you can write this as secant theta minus 1, secant theta plus 1 is equal to tan square theta. And again, you can see that secant theta minus 1 upon tan theta can be written as tan theta upon secant theta plus 1, right? So, and vice versa, meaning, so secant theta plus 1 upon tan theta is equal to tan theta upon secant theta minus 1. So you must remember these manifestations also. Okay, next. Same thing again, no need to, you know, break your head into proving of this. So it's a theta A B C P B H, and what is, so CSE is cosecant. So this is written in short form, cosecant, COCSC. Okay. Now, 1 plus cot square theta. 1 plus cot square theta is nothing but 1 plus cot theta. Cot theta is adjacent by opposite. So, B by P whole square, which is nothing but 1 plus B square by P square, which is nothing but B P square plus B square by P square, which is nothing but H square by P square, which is cosecant square theta. So this is the proof. And then again, same thing what we did for the last identity, 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosecant square theta. So again, you can write cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. So all these different varieties must be in your mind quick. So you should be able to relate to solve the problem quick, right? So hence, this can be written as cosecant theta minus cot theta will be reciprocal of cosecant theta plus cot theta. So keep this in mind again. You don't need to mug up, but you please keep in mind that, okay, this is how these identities or these ratios can be expressed. Okay, similarly, you can do the reverse. So cosecant theta plus cot theta is reciprocal of cosecant theta minus cot theta, right? And the final one, what we did the other way on the secant wala identity as well, cosecant square theta minus 1 is equal to cot square theta, okay? So which is nothing but cosecant theta minus 1 by cot theta, I'm writing directly, is equal to cot theta. You can relate by the previous example, cosecant theta plus 1. Correct? And the other way around, which is cot theta or cosecant theta or whichever way. So you can write like that also, cosecant theta minus 1 is equal to cosecant theta plus 1 by cot theta. Okay, is that okay? Is that okay? So this is the basic understanding of identities. So everything you will be doing now will be combination of whatever we just did. Nothing more, nothing less. Okay, so here is a grid which you don't need to mug up, but you must be having it with you. The slides will be with you. So hence, you can go through. What we have done is all the trigonometric identities have been expressed in terms of the other. So you can ignore the minus part here because you are not dealing with any angle greater than 90. So in all the plus minus you see, you just can keep only plus. Minus you can ignore for the time being. Okay. So this is how sine theta is related to sine theta, how sine theta is related to cos theta, how sine theta is related to tan theta, how sine is related to cosecant, secant, and cot like that. So all interrelationships are there. So you can keep as a, you know, some kind of handy result. You don't need to mug anything from here. And yeah, so let's start right away with this. So as you know, there will be one marker. If there is any identity question, there will be either one, can be two, can be three as well. So one, two, three. There will not be, I think, any question for five marker because five marker usually would be for height and distance. So you can expect any question one, two, three, or you know, one marker, two marker, three marker. So I think minimum of 3 marks for of identities would definitely be there. Maximum of 4 marks, not beyond that, I believe. But anyways, so our maximum here anyways will be 5. So there will be, as you know, there are how many questions from trigonometry? Total is 12 marks. So there is 1 plus 1, 2 1-marker, 1 2-marker, 1 3-marker, and 1 5-marker. So total is 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 5, 12. So this is the structure for trigonometry. So in out of these two, one here, one will be of Daksh. You're saying something, Daksh?
No, sir, just a mistake. I was just opening the chat.
No problem. So 1 plus 1, and so 1 could be trigonometry, 2 could be trigonometry, 3 could be trigonometry. Okay, so you know the trigonometry identity. So at max 5 marks for trigonometric identities. Okay, so let's begin, guys. So here is the first question. This is given in the sample paper, which is published by CBSE. So it should not be a big deal. So could you find x plus y? Oh, all of you have done already. So 3, very good. So how would I write it? And you must also need to check the marking scheme, guys. So in marking scheme, the previous class, I forgot to tell you that in the heights and distance question, there is 1 mark for diagram only. Okay, 1 mark is on diagram. So don't miss that diagram, right? 1 mark on diagram. So draw it very, very neatly. And then every other step is half a mark, you know, worth half a mark. So every step you write, you will get half a mark like that. Though people do not go into that deeper detail, but then once, you know, while correcting it, but definitely, since it is given that diagram will have 1 mark, so you will get 1 mark if you have drawn the diagram correctly. Okay, so keep that in mind. So last time we could not discuss that. Now, in case of trigonometric identities, many a times the question comes whether I can do both LHS, RHS and all that. So usually the practice is to start from LHS or go to RHS or to start from RHS and go to LHS, whichever way. But it's not, you know, very sacrosanct, so to say. But let's say if you are stuck totally, you can always do that, where you can, you know, you start from both sides and prove eventually. But the questions which are there, you'll see the previous year questions also. In none of these questions, you will be, you know, finding that difficult to prove. Okay, so very clearly, so x plus y is given, nothing to do. So x plus y is nothing but you write directly 2 sine square theta plus 2 cos square theta plus 1. Then you take 2 common and then write sine square theta plus cos square theta plus 1, and then write 2 times 1 plus 1. Now here, there's an important thing. Now, many a times you have forgotten to write the reason. And let's say this reason, because sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Let's say you have missed it. Okay. Now, many a times people do what? They directly jump from here and they write 3. Answer as 3. Instead of that, I would say, even if you know the answer, try to write like in this form, 2 times 1 plus 1, which clearly indicates that you know that this 1 has to come here. Is that understood? Give me a thumbs up if you understood the point. The point is, you can always write 3 directly, you know, in the want of time. But while you're doing it, and let's say if you have forgotten this crucial thing where reasons are, you know, the proper identity has to be mentioned to, you know, attract marks. But if you have forgotten, or let's say, sorry, this is a good practice to, you know, write this step 2 times 1 plus 1 like that. Okay, fair enough. So this is, answer is 3. All of you know this. Next. So the value of this is, and you know, your entire trigonometry 1 is the number to chase, right? 1 is the number to chase. And this is very, very simple again. So you'll write sine square theta plus 1 upon secant square theta, right? Why? Because 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. We just learned that. And hence it is sine square theta plus cos square theta. Why? Because 1 by secant theta is equal to cos theta. And hence it is 1. Okay, done. Next. This one, again, number to chase. You know, the favorite number to chase here is 1. These are all one marker. This was asked in 2020 board paper. Okay, so again, the value of this is nothing but 1 plus tan square theta times 1 minus sine square theta, 1 minus sine square theta. If you have time, you can write A plus B, A minus B, but this is a one marker, so you can avoid that. And then 1 plus tan square theta can be written as secant square theta. And this is, wait, somebody just joined. Okay, anyway, so secant square theta plus, sorry, not plus, into cos square theta is equal to 1. Why? Within the brackets, you write secant theta into cos theta is equal to 1. Done. Next. If sine A plus sine square A is 1, then find the value of expression cos square A plus cos to the power 4A. Let me know if you could do it. Yeah, what's the answer? Type in. So it is 1. Without doubt. Okay, so how to do it? How to do it? So sine A plus sine square A. Now this is mouth-watering. Sine square A is the term. So sine A clearly is 1 minus sine square A, which is cos square A. So sine A itself is cos square A. Okay, now cos square A plus cos to the power 4 A is equal to sine A plus sine square A, isn't it? Why? Because we just proved that cos square A is equal to sine A. And this is already given 1 here. So done. Yes, Navya, please rejoin, but you can't hear. How do I? Yep, you can. Anyone who cannot, who's facing any technical glitch, can rejoin. Okay, next. Next one marker. What is the value of So you can see there are lots of ones around. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Right, very, very easy. So one marker will be very, very easy. So you have secured 1 out of 12 for sure. So 1 by 1 plus cot square. So it is nothing but 1 upon 1 plus cot square is cosecant square theta plus 1 upon secant square theta is equal to sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. And you can always write your reasons that secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta, and cosecant square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta, like that. Okay, so this is done, one mark over. Now, yes, simplest form of 1 plus tan square a by 1 plus cot square a. Is writing reason compulsory? You in one marker you can avoid, or you can, you know, leave. But for three markers and all, yes, please write wherever it is, wherever you feel that the, you know, wherever you are using anything. Okay, now the thing is, as I told you, you'll have enough time, lots of time. So let's say in the first go, you did not write or you missed it. Then in the second round, when you are revising, no. So it's easy on the right hand side, it will be enough space will be there. Just keep on writing the reasons in the next round when you're revising. Is it understood? Hence we divided the time accordingly. So you have 15-20 minutes in the next round. In fact, more than that. So always come back and keep writing wherever you think that there is some scope of writing the reason. Okay, so it's, yeah, answer is tan square a. And I don't think I need to prove it. So 1 plus tan square is directly secant square a. And we have divided by 1 plus cot square a is cosecant square a, which is tan square a, or you can also write one more step, that is sine square a by cos square a. Okay, so which is nothing but sine by cos is tan square a. Done. So one markers are pretty simple, right? So none of you should be losing any single mark here. So what is our objective? What is our objective, guys? Just to remind you, our objective. What are we chasing? What are we trying to get? Yes, centum. So everyone should be only chasing centum. In centum, get centum. Okay, so centum. Yes. So centum has to be there. 100 marks is very doable. Okay, next. Here. Now we are going to three marker identities, which have been there in the previous year papers. So here is the first one, very, very simple one, I believe. I think you will be able to do it. And there could be multiple ways of solving the same one. Acha. One more piece of advice before you attempt. Now there is someone who is entering without a proper name. Okay, so who is this guy? Just a minute. People do not understand a simple fact. Sorry, can't let them enter. Okay, yes, guys, what I was saying is, before you attempt identity problem, it is always advisable, ek bar check kar lo, whether the identity is true or not, correct or not, because many times what happens, you will see that it is, you know, not true, maybe, so hence it is always advisable. So best for tan and cot, if it is there, you can use 45 degrees. And you can, just a minute here. Who is this bugger? Unknown person. Random name. Random names, people will not be entertained in the class. Okay. I must know you. Okay. Prove that. One. So hence done. Srijani has done. Anyone else? All proved. Akshita also done. Very good. And if you look at it very carefully, guys, it is nothing but we just discussed above. See, this has come in the board paper. Isn't it? We have just discussed above manifestation of this one. Dekho. This is based on this. Yes or no? This is based on this part. So cot square theta is equal to cosecant square theta minus 1. That's it. And done. So it is based on that manifestation only. So what is this? So I told you that cot square alpha is equal to cosecant square alpha minus 1. Isn't it? So hence, I can write cot square alpha is equal to cosecant alpha minus 1 and cosecant alpha plus 1. Okay, so hence this is nothing but cot square alpha divided by cosecant alpha plus 1 is equal to cosecant alpha minus 1. So this implies cos, you can write cot, or you can write here cot square alpha divided by, this is cosecant alpha plus 1, or 1 plus cosecant alpha plus 1 is equal to cosecant alpha, hence proved, right? So this is again, so if you, in such questions, do not try to reduce into cos and sine directly. When you see, when you're seeing cosecant and cot clearly, so this was, this one has to be taken here like that, and you could have got the clue. Oh, correct. Is that understood? Any doubt how to approach identities? Yes, I was saying you can also prove it. Take alpha is 45 degrees, so cot 45 is 1. So 1 plus, how much is it? 1 plus 2. So cot square alpha. So you can, or you can take LCM and solve. You can do that. I told you there are multiple ways of doing it. Till you get the LHS equal to RHS, you can do all sorts of permutation combination. But again, what I see in this, we spent how many steps? 1, 2, 3, 4, done. So, you know, there you could adopt any method which is helping you. No problems at all. Okay, here, next one. This is very simple, straightforward. Very, very simple and straightforward. Just say done when done. Just say done when done. Okay. Quick. All of you, where are there? There are 90 people, 90 plus people. Come on, guys. Where is the energy? Boss, centum clinic ke liye energy. You need energy, 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 high energy. Done, 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 done. Quick, quick, quick. Very good, very good. It's very much possible. Centum is within reach. So hence, everyone should get 100 on 100. No less. If more, I don't mind, but not less. Okay. Yeah. Come on. Done. Everyone done. Yes. Even if you know, even if you know the question, even if you know the question, solve it. Even if you know the question, solve it. Solve properly. Solve and see whether you are writing and your, you know, thought processes are correct or not. So I know most of the questions would be very easy. You would have done it, whether in the PTs or in your mock exams which you are writing, wherever. But there is no problem in doing once again. Okay, so how to do it? Very, very easy. I would have taken, so I'll start with LHS. LHS is equal to tan square theta plus tan to the power 4 theta, which is equal to tan square common theta 1 plus tan square theta. Isn't it? Now, tan square theta itself can be written as secant square theta minus 1. And 1 plus tan square theta can be written as secant square theta, and the job is done. Secant 4 theta minus secant square theta. Within this, I will write, since secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. Done. Okay. And you get 3 marks and you get closer to centum. Okay. Next. So this is another variety where they are equating something to some third variable. Right, P and Q are there. So you have to simply substitute into LHS, arrive at RHS. This is another way of testing identity, you know, your skills in identities. Okay, so simple, don't need to do anything. Substitute, calculate, and complete the process. The best part about identities is that you know the end result. So there is absolutely no way you can go wrong. Right. So hence, you know the end result in proving questions. So it becomes much easier. Yeah, done. So all done, we'll say done. So Monish is done, Shreyas done, Arundhati done, Shobita done, Pranav done, Aditi done, Akshita done. Very good. Anish also done, Aniket, Srijani, Vaishnav, Surya, Anirudh, Sharon. Great, guys. Good. Siddharth, Kartik done. Very good. Ananya, Aryan. Very good. Nice. Monish also done. Monish Gowda done. Very good, guys. So simple again. So what to do? Q. Be very, very careful. What is being asked for? Secant theta plus cosecant theta is Q. multiplied by p square. So write sine theta plus cos theta whole squared. This is p square minus 1. Right? So you have to arrive at 2p. So 2p, keep in mind, is nothing but 2 times sine theta plus cos theta. Very good. So what do I need to do? So I have an expansion to do here. So secant theta plus cosecant theta into sine square theta plus cos square theta plus 2 sine theta cos theta minus 1. This is the thing. Right? Simple. So hence, now first, let's simplify this. Secant theta plus cosecant theta. Since it is 3 markers, so I'll write 1 plus 2 sine theta cos theta minus 1. And here I will write the reason. Sine square theta plus cos square theta equals 1. And then I will cancel 1 and this 1. So while you're canceling, make sure that, you know, whatever it is being canceled is also visible, right? So that the examiner knows what are you trying to do. So then this is nothing but 2 times, you can write now, sine theta cos theta times 1 by cos theta plus 1 upon sine theta. Like that you can write, or you can write directly as well, no problems. So it is 2 times sine theta cos theta by cos theta plus 2 times sine theta cos theta by sine theta. So now, so hence it is 2 common, sine theta plus cos theta, which is nothing but 2 times p. Fair enough. Any problem? Anyone wants? All clear, all good. Any issues, any glitches, any concern? Right, so far so good. So we are nearing closing in towards center. Okay, so please maintain your, you know, pace and keep yourself calm as well. Okay, here, next one. Now this is again one of the manifestations which we talked about, and you will be able to do it. Board paper question. Okay, Surya has done it. Very good. Monish, Aditi, Siddharth. Very good. So the hint is you have to divide the numerator and denominator with something. Okay, very good. So most of you have anyways done it. So hint is you have to divide the numerator in such cases where you have secant and tan on the RHS and sine and cos on the left hand side. So yes, so simply divide numerator and denominator by cos. So hence, and you have to write also. So you have to write dividing numerator and denominator by cos theta. Okay, you will get LHS is equal to sine by cos theta minus cos theta by cos theta. Now, many a times it appears to be too much work to write all that is obvious, but my dear friends, you have to make clear in the minds of the examiner that you know it. So hence you have to walk that path. So sine theta by cos theta minus 1 upon cos theta. And anyways, it's a matter of just 3 months now from here on. So it is nothing but, you can see, tan theta and then minus 1 plus secant theta. And in the denominator, we have 1 plus tan theta minus secant theta. And now there is a catch. Yes. Now there is a catch. Again, this one is going to rescue you out. And since the thing is in the denominator, so we'll only go for that substitution in the denominator. So what will you do? You will write this as secant theta plus tan theta minus 1, just rearranging the terms in the numerator, divided by. So 1 in the denominator can be expressed as, secant square theta minus tan square theta. And this is the catch in this identity, plus tan theta minus secant theta. And you'll see that the numerator and denominator, you'll get a common term. So what is this? So secant theta plus tan theta minus 1. And now you can say secant theta minus tan theta into secant theta plus tan theta, and extend it. And here take minus 1 common and write secant theta minus tan theta. Okay, so what will you get? You will get secant theta plus tan theta minus 1 divided by secant theta minus tan theta. So this is, if you would have seen, you're already there in the, you've got the destination wala part. Okay, and what is there in the common thing? Secant theta. Secant theta plus tan theta minus 1. And you can see numerator and denominator has a common factor. Once this entire thing and this entire thing will go, and you get the RHS, secant theta minus tan theta. Okay. So the catch was, what to do? So there are, one indication was that RHS is secant tan. So I have to divide by cos to get secant tan in the LHS as well. And then one of the ones, because there is three terms, and on the RHS, there are two terms in the denominator. That means you have to create a pair somewhere. So I chose this to create a pair, and then I could solve it. Okay, clear guys, right? So this is three marker again. So you can mark this as a star problem where some substitution was done, and you just have a look before your exams again. Okay, next. So radical sign questions. Here you know what to do. Whenever there is a radical sign question, you have to try to multiply and divide by conjugates, right? Yep. So this is very easy. Surya is already done. So whenever there is a square, try to eliminate the square root sign. And how can you eliminate the square root sign? By completing the square method, or not completing the square method, making it perfect square somehow. So most of you have already done. Easy problem. Folks, easy. Tell me very honestly, so far, was there any question which was too hard? Any question which was very hard? And oh my God, trigonometry is like, it's not my cup of tea. I cannot do well in trigonometry. Oh, I'm scared of trigonometry, right? So you can see I have not fabricated these questions myself. These are all board papers. All previously asked questions or the sample papers which have been given by the board. And mostly these are, you must have done that in the school as well. Okay. So how to do, as I told you, whenever you see a radical sign question, radical sign meaning wherever this sign is there, what to do, you will try to, and then on the right hand side, there is no such sign. So obviously you have to do something to eliminate a square root sign. And how to eliminate a square root sign? Don't say rationalize. Because even if you multiply by the 1 plus sine a, the result, you will not get as a rational factor. Sine theta is not always rational. Okay, so rationalization is a wrong term to use. You basically do what? Multiply and divide by the conjugates. What is conjugates? 1 minus sine a conjugate is 1 plus sine a, like that, right? So hence, what do you do? You do this. So LHS is equal to root over 1 plus sine a divided by 1 minus sine a, and then multiply this with root over, you can do that also. Instead of root over, you could have done directly, but I do not have a eraser in front of me. So a 1 plus sine a and divided by 1 plus sine a. This is what I have done. So which is nothing but root over 1 plus sine a ka whole square. And in the denominator, I will get 1 minus sine square a, right? which is nothing but root over, let me write, 1 plus sine a whole squared divided by cos square a. So hence, nothing but 1 plus sine a, and the root is gone because I created perfect squares. Right? And this is 1 upon cos a plus sine a by cos a. Sorry. Which is secant a plus tan a. Done. And you can always write here sine square a plus cos square a is 1. Done, guys. Why can't we just square on both sides? See, again, Prisham, the thing is, usually we take this root. Again, it's not wrong. You can do that. But usually, the standard conventional methodology is to take one side and go to the other side. Okay, so when you square it and try to prove, it will not be a wrong thing to do. But again, as I told you, you know, instead of taking risk, let's go by the convention. We start from one side, go to the other side. Prisham, clear? So try avoiding, you know, doing something to the entire equation maybe. Okay, chalo, next. Oh, this is so very, very simple. This should be one marker. I don't know why they have given us 3 marks. Su Sandhya, Aryan, Su Sandhya. You are late today as you had gone out. What do you do out? There is nothing to do outside. Lots of coronavirus there and there. Why do you go out? Oh, acha, okay. I hope all well. Cool. Chalo, solve it. Cot A minus cos A upon cot A plus cos A equals cosecant A minus 1 upon cosecant A plus 1. It's like kesari bath, halwa. Very easy question. Piece of cake. Isn't it? Trigonometry is easy. In fact, maths entirely is easy. Very easy subject. Everyone should study maths. Okay, done. Everyone. Aray, where is the energy? Yaar, only 15-20 people are responding. Where are all? Watching India-Australia match, huh? Oh, that's over, I think. India-Australia match is over, no? The test match. Are you watching the highlights? Vaishnav got interested now. Okay, over, huh? Who won? Australia. Oh, you are. Okay, Surya. Surya is playing game. Doesn't know, he says. okay, chalo. So let's come back to trigonometry. Cot A minus cos A by cot A plus cos A, dude. So what do you do? Okay, who suggests? What to do? Divide or something, multiply, divide? Yes or no? Yes. So divide simply by cos and done. So hence you write dividing numerator and denominator of LHS by cos A. You will get cot A by cos A minus 1 divided by cot A by cos A minus 1. Sorry, plus 1. And done. So cot A by cos A anyways is cosecant A. Cosecant A minus 1. So one step. Cosecant A plus 1. And you have to mention, but cot A is equal to cos A by sine A is equal to cos A into cosecant A. Yes, one step. That's what I'm saying. So they have given in sample paper, no? So anyways, chalo. No worries. Let's go to this one. This is the sister of the first one. So do I need to prove this? No need. Same thing. So what is the dividing thing here? What will you divide it with? What will you divide it with? Sine. Very good. So divide simply by sine. So you'll get tan A by sine A plus 1 by tan A by sine A minus 1. So they've just played with the signs and same thing. So tan A by sine A is, so you can always write sine A by cos A into sine A. So I've written tan as this plus 1. And then, so see brackets here and there to make sure that, you know, the examiner follows what you're trying to do is always beneficial. So write like that, minus 1, right? So sine sine goes. So this becomes sine sine goes. So 1 upon cos A plus 1 by 1 upon cos A minus 1. So hence it is secant A plus 1 divided by secant A minus 1. Hence proved. Not a big deal. Chalo ye karo. So you can see this is a scanned copy of the board paper. So you can see the texture of the background of the question also is reflecting. Just expand. No, don't expand yourself. Yeah. Done. So without just seeing the question, done. Hey. Right. Even if you know it, you should write. Akshita, Daksh, Aditi. Right, right, right. I can't. Oh, no, really done. Oh, good. Does CBSE plagiarize from RDS or something? Ulta, ulta, dost. All these authors have been connected to one of the agencies, schools, institutions like that. Okay, done. Very simple. Very, very simple. So as Daksh was mentioning, expand. Yes, expansion is great. So let's expand. So Bahya Disha mein LHS is equal to expand. So it is sine square theta plus cosecant square theta plus 2 times sine theta times cosecant theta plus cos square theta plus secant square theta plus 2 times cos theta secant theta, right? Now club, so this is equal to sine square theta plus cos square theta, and then cosecant square ko kya likhenge? We will write this as plus cot square theta plus 1, and then 2 sine theta cos theta is simply 2, and then this is gone. Secant square ko likhenge tan square theta plus 1, and this is again 2. So hence this is 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 2. Aur ek 1 kahan gaya? 1 plus 1 also. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus tan square theta plus cot square theta. So this entire thing is 7. 7 plus tan square theta and cot square theta. And here, write all the identities together because all of them are used. So write sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Then write secant square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. And third, cosecant square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. That's it. Done. Cool. One more inch towards centum. Next. ये करो. So who's saying done? Daksh and Monish saying done. What did you do? Akshita also says done. Daksh bhai, what did you do?
So we write cot as cos by sine and cosecant as 1 by sine and just convert everything into sine and cos. And we simplify the two multiplication brackets and then we multiply it. Get a square minus b square at the top and now it will be sine into cos.
So did you sine and cos convert Madi? Akshita, what's your process? Can you unmute and say? Akshita is there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, the same thing. Cot A, cosec A, tan A and sec A. If we convert everything to sine A and cos A, it is, when we simplify it, we get 2.
Oh, is it? Okay. Did you expand or not? Did you multiply? Did you multiply the 2? So you will get what? 3 into 3, 9 terms. Did you get that? Or no? Manish, what is Manish's process? Substituting cot as sine in cos and cosecant as 1 upon the same thing and then expand. Is that what you did?
Yes, sir.
Any other method? Did anyone solve without expanding? I was just curious to know. You multiplied and then substituted. Okay. Can this sum be done without multiplication? Is that possible? No. Yes or no? Anyway, so one thing is very clear that we can definitely multiply and get that. So hence, instead of expanded only. So let's say if you expand, what will you get? First is 1 plus tan A plus secant A. Then you will get plus cot A. Then plus cot A tan A. So you now know your fodder is here. Cot A tan A. And 1. So that is 2. That is all others will get added up to 0. Okay. Never mind. Let's begin. Okay, continue. So cot A secant A. Then third expansion minus cosecant A. Minus cosecant A tan A. And then minus cosecant A secant A. Perfect. These are 9 terms. So count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Perfect. Perfect. Now, so you now know what do you know? This is one. So let's write 1 plus tan A plus secant A plus cot A. So I don't know the fate of all of this plus 1 plus cot A secant A. What will this be? Cos A, it is nothing but cosecant A. Yes or no? Am I right? Yep. Now, this is minus cosecant A, so you got the pair. Now, cosecant tan A is minus secant A. Isn't it? And this is minus cosecant A secant A. Let it be like that. So, beta G, gone. Anything all? Any kuch aur bacha gaya? No. So, answer is 2 plus tan A is sine A by cos A. Now I will change it. Then cot A is cos A by sine A. Minus what? 1 upon cos A sine A. And then done. Over. Game's over. Why? Because this is 2 plus take sine and cos as common denominator. And then here it is nothing but sine square A plus cos square A minus 1, which is 0. This item is 0. Hence, you can write 2 plus 1 minus 1 upon sine A cos A. Barabar 2. Okay. And all the reasons again. Bracket with Tino identity. All the three put together. Write it down. Yep. So let me write it down. So sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1 secant square theta. That is not required, I believe. So this is not required. And you can always write cosecant A into what was that? Which got killed. Cosecant into tan A is equal to what? Secant A. And the third one also you have to write like that. Just write. Fair enough. Done. Any problem? So 3 into 3, 9 terms, multiplication and done. Okay, this one. Oh, this is same. We are not doing it. This is again, see, there's a repetition. Question is repeated. Let's not do it. This one. Haan ji, ye kariye. Do this. Even if you have done this, seen this, please, for God's sake, do it. Do properly. As if you are viewing it for the first time. Akshita is done. Monish done. Two people. Come on, Josh. Energy. Pranav done. Aniket Gupta is done. Char log. Come on, Daksh Singh done. Very good. Come on, guys. That's a hint. How many of you want hint? No one. Anyone wants hint? Oh, Aditi also, Medha, Aryan, Aditya, done. Aditya, done? Others? Srishti, done. Very good. Anushka, Shobita, very good. Very good. Moving towards centum. Good. Keep it up, guys. Srijani done. Very good, Srijani. What is the difficulty coefficient so far? Questions? Easy? Difficult? Crazy? E, D, C. What is the survey? So far? E. Andrila says C. Crazy. E, D, C. Easy, difficult, or crazy? Totally weird. E. All of you are E. Very good. Nice. Good going, guys. Good going. Chalo. Keep the momentum going. And how to solve this? So hint was simply, I would touch one of the two terms, not both. See, this is the beauty. 1 minus cot theta can be converted into 1 minus tan and vice versa. So what I'll do is, I will do this part. So tan theta, let's say, yes, or 1 minus cot theta can be written as 1 upon cot theta minus tan theta by cot theta. Can I do that? Bolo. Oh, this is required. Yes. Some easy, some are okay. Aryan single. Yes. Any other route? So what I'll do is I will touch only one instead of both. Or what I can do is tan 1 by tan is cot. And yes, guys, even in terms of sine. Or you have changed it into sine and cos? Yeshika? Yeah. So every cot into tan. Yeah, that will be better actually. Yes. Basically, yes. That is better to do. So what I'll do is, I have done, yeah, tan, cot ko tan mein change karu, that's better. Yes, correct. So tan upon 1 minus cot, and cot can be written as, so let me rewrite this part. This is 1 upon tan, and this is 1 minus tan theta. Very good. Oh, this cot also will be changed. So let me erase everything. Let me erase. No ghachpach. All clear. Very clear, neat, and so if you are, let's say you got stuck somewhere and you have to delete anything, don't paint there. Just simply, you know, strike it off and move forward. So tan theta, and this is 1 minus 1 upon tan theta. That's what I was saying. And this is 1 upon tan theta by 1 minus tan theta. And this will give you 1 minus tan theta in the denominator. So if you see, this is tan square theta. This tan theta will go up here. And this will become tan square, tan theta minus 1. And this can be written as, plus 1 upon tan theta minus tan square theta. Did I do the correct thing? Tan theta, let it be tan theta, sorry, 1 by tan theta.
Don't multiply, yeah, sir.
Yes. So tan theta 1 minus tan theta, so that I can take common, right? Now, what do? I take tan theta minus 1 as common, 1 upon tan theta minus 1 as common. So what do I get? I get tan, hey, just check the calculation, tan theta goes up, tan square, yes, better, tan theta minus 1 plus 1 upon tan theta, 1 minus tan theta, perfect. So I take, let's say, 1 upon 1 minus tan theta as common. So what am I left with? I'm left with minus tan square theta. And what's here? Plus 1 upon tan theta. Am I right? So far, so good. Yes or no? Sine and cos seems friendly. You can do that, no problem. So this is nothing but you will get 1 upon 1 minus tan theta. And then if you rewrite it, this is tan theta in the denominator. And in the numerator, you will get 1 minus tan cube theta. I hope this makes sense. Correct. So what? So now 1 minus tan theta will go from the bottom, you know, denominator. So it is nothing but 1 minus tan cube can be written as 1 minus tan theta 1 plus tan square theta plus tan theta. A cube minus B cube form. Divided by 1 minus tan theta into tan theta. So this will go. Now simply. So this is 1 by tan theta. Is how much? 1 by tan theta is cot theta. Correct? So hence, I am getting, anyways, 1 plus tan square theta can be written as secant square theta. Will that help? Will that help? So, now here you can reduce sine and cos everything so that you'll get 1 by 1 plus cos and yes. So reduce everything to sine and cos. So 1 plus sine square theta by cos square theta plus sine theta by cos theta divided by sine theta by cos theta. Sorry for the lack of space. I'm writing here. Okay. So what will be the numerator like? Numerator will be cos square theta plus sine square theta.
Sir, or else we can directly 1 plus tan square theta is equal to secant square theta. That
anything you can do. And in the denominator, cos square aa gaya. So this is cos square theta and into cos theta by sin theta. This is what I am getting. Okay. So you can just divide by tan theta. Anything will do. Anything. If you are able to solve, please. So whatever striking my head, I am doing that. So 1 by sin theta cos theta divided by cos square theta. This is cos theta times sin theta. And done. This is what you wanted. Isn't it? Because this is nothing but secant theta plus cosecant theta. At times you might veer away, no problem. But then, ek do step jada lagega, but you'll get it. Okay, never mind. So there could be multiple ways of solving again. So there could be tan, as Surya was mentioning, tan ko you straight away write sine by cos, cot ko cos by sine, and do simplifications, and you will end up getting that. Theek hai? Fair enough. But this deserves 3 marks. Chalo. Yes, that also can help. No problem. You can do that, Aditya. So you can start with sine and sine by cos and eventually get the RHS, whichever works. There will be multiple roots in identities. Next, this one. Thank you. Daksh and Munish. Very good. In these kind of question, there is one thing you can do. Yes, Aryan, I'll explain. Achha, I'll give all of you a hint. It will become easier if you do this. What? Take this entire thing on the left hand side. You don't need to convert anything. Just take that part to the left hand side. Good Srishti, good Aditi, very good. So the moment you take it to the other side, it will be very, very simple. No problem, Monish. You see, the thing is, you don't start from here. Let's say you start from this part. That's what I'm saying. So you don't start from whatever it's given. So can I not start like this? You can do that. No problem at all. What I'm doing is this. I will show you. Dekho. Cot minus cosecant. No, you don't need to. Dekho. What I'm saying is, this is as good as proving sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus sine theta upon cot theta minus cosecant theta, right, is equal to 2. This is, so this identity is, now you can always define the identity like that. So prove this, no problem. So what is this sine theta common? So let's take sine theta common, and then what you will get, cot theta minus cosecant theta, then minus cot theta and minus cosecant theta divided by cot square theta minus cosecant square theta. Okay. And then what is it? This is nothing but sine theta. And here this cot theta item will go. And this is minus 2 cosecant theta divided by minus 1. Isn't it cot square theta minus cosecant is right? And then hence it is 2 into sine theta into cosecant theta. Sir, so we are allowed to transpose expression in proving question C. In the initial, you can redefine it. That's not on. Let's say you don't want to transpose it. Now you know how to, once, let's say if you want to do like that only. So now you know how to get to this level, and then you rearrange the terms and you know, rain. But in my opinion, this is okay. There's no problem. Both LHS and RHS to be 1 cos theta and equate. Both LHS, that is what is, Aditya, in my opinion, don't do that together. Don't do together, LHS, RHS together. So what I did is, I just so this identity is this. So I've just recreated the identity, and I did not do together. I started from LHS once and then ended up getting RHS in that case. Okay. So you can do adopt this method. No problem. Right. Or else if you don't want to do that, then what? Or you have to do this. No, not. Or yes, you can do from RHS as well, but 2 is a problem here. So what otherwise you can do is, you can start like this. LHS sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus 1. You start like this. Okay. Minus 1. So is equal to, and then you prove this to be equal to 1 plus sine theta by cot theta minus cosecant theta. Okay. So what is this? Sine theta minus cot theta minus cosecant theta divided by cot theta plus cosecant theta. Isn't it? Now you want cot minus cosecant in the denominator. Isn't it? So hence, what will you do? Will that help? So if I get that, and sine also outside. So one way, otherwise is, now what you need to do is, once you have done that, okay, then you can write this as one, then you write this as one plus sine theta minus cot theta minus cosecant theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus one. Can I write like that? Can I or not? Is it okay? See, I'm trying to, you know, slowly move towards my destination. So hence, if I prove somehow, is that okay? So far, so good. I just added one and minus one. Yes or no? Did you get the point? Guys, I need a confirmation. Are you with me? Is that okay? So I simply started with LHS, subtracted one from it. Okay. And then tried to simplify. And then I added one and minus one. So why? Because this one is needed here. So I took, I split this two. One was, sorry. Hello? Saying something? Someone was saying something. Anyways, now why am I not, you know, doing sine and cos again? Because I have to come back to cot and cosecant. So hence I am getting some kind of hints from here. Now, can you see that? Let us now resolve this further. So let me write it here. What is this? This is 1 plus sine minus cot minus cot theta, and then what is it? Oh, wait. People are getting disconnected or what? Beach mein joining. 1 minute. So sine theta minus cot theta minus cosecant theta minus cot theta and minus cosecant theta. Isn't it? Divided by cot theta plus cosecant theta. Right? Now this cot and this cot will go. Okay. So this cot and this cot will go. So what is left? Is equal to 1 plus. So just because you wanted to do from LHS to RHS, we are doing this. So 1 plus sine theta. Okay. I want sine theta also. So I'm taking one plus sine theta. And what is left inside? Okay, first let us simplify this. So this is minus 2 cosecant theta divided by cot theta plus cosecant theta. So this will, you know, get stretched a bit. So sine, I can take common 2 by cos square and cot. Yeah. So I just need some space actually to move forward. Okay, wait. Where do I go? I don't have. See, okay. Anyways, what I'm trying to say is here you can extract sine again. So some space I will extract. So 1 plus sine theta. And then what is this? 1 minus 2 upon. Maybe I asked for 5 marker, right? See, you never know. You know, there is. So hence, for the 3 marker part, I have already showed you how to do it. Oh, sorry. Correct. But just in case you want, you can do it. You know, you need some more space to solve. That's it. But I'm saying you can try this. I this is very much doable. So this is 1 by 2 sine square theta. Sorry, I don't have space here. 1 minute. And wait. Ruk jao. Now let us finish it. Oh, if I remove it, everything will go. Oh. Oh, okay. It's there. Chalo, theek hai, no problem. So what I was saying is this. Let me copy, paste. So what? Where was I? Huh? So dekho, don't lose patience. Huh? We'll solve it. Oh, come here. No, this is creating trouble. Wait a minute, guys. Wait. Huh. Okay, so what I was saying is this, that we had 1 minus am I able to write? Yeah. Now, so what was the thing? Thing was, let me just copy. So 1 plus sine minus cot minus cosecant. So 1 plus sine theta minus cot theta minus cosecant theta divided by cot theta plus cosecant theta. I hope this was correct. This or then minus 1 also, isn't it? Let's check once again. Sine theta plus sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus 1, sine minus cot minus cosecant divided by this. So this is 1 plus and minus. Very good. So now let's proceed from here. So hence, what do I get? I get 1 plus sine theta minus cot theta minus cosecant theta minus cot theta minus cosecant theta. So I'm taking LCM either and divide by cot theta plus cosecant theta. That's what I wanted to do there. Okay, so this cot and this cot will go, and I am left with 1 plus, and let the sine theta thing come out because I anyways need sine theta. So this will be 1 minus 2 cosecant. So, yes, sir.
So how are you canceling cot theta?
I'm sorry, this is minus. Oh, sorry. Huh? My bad. I thought it is plus. Thanks for this thing. So it is not going to be canceled. Thank you. So delete it. I thought it was plus. It was supposed to get subtracted. But anyways, chalo, theek hai. So anyway, so 1 plus, what am I doing? I am now taking sine theta minus 2.
So better we can take the plus 1 part. Will be then cot will get cancelled.
Better you take plus 1, but then I need plus 1 here. No, I can't take plus 1 root because one is sacrosanct. I can't leave 1. This is the part of the question. Okay, isn't it? So this has to be there. So understood, why am I not touching this one and this one? I'm taking this one because simply because I need that one. Anyways, just bear with me for some time. So 2 plus cosecant theta. Ye theek hai, bolo. So far, so good. Am I right? Yep. So far, so good. So hence, I need what? I need one more sign. Right? So 1 plus sine theta. I'm extracting now. Now, tell me whether I'm right or not. 2. So cot by sine. So this will be cot theta by sine theta plus cosecant theta by sine theta divided by cot theta plus cosecant theta. Am I right, guys? Is it making sense? So see, I'm step by step, I'm getting what I intend to, right? But now there is one more problem. What is that problem? I need minus over here. So what is the problem? Let's introduce minus. So cot theta minus cosecant theta say aap divide kar dijiye. So if you really want to do like that, now I get this, and yahan pe you multiply also cot theta minus cosecant theta. And now what is our job? Our job is to show that this is 1. Yes or no? So that's, if that is 1, can you just, you can just separate the denominator in the previous step. How?
Oh, so like you can take sine theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta minus 2 cot theta plus cosecant theta by cot theta plus cosecant theta.
you separate, but then my problem, Aditya, is I need a negative sign in the denominator. It is not the plus sign here, no. So see, what is the sign here? Negative.
Oh, yes, so sorry.
So we have to get a negative sign over there. So all this tamasha is because of that. Right? So now if you see, we are getting the intended result. 1 plus sine theta upon cot theta minus cosecant theta, right? No? Why 1 here? Because one of the ones you have taken on the left-hand side here. You can see that one here. I hope this pointer is visible. So now you have to just, simplify somehow and prove that this is actually, or this entire thing, the top one, is nothing but cot theta plus cosecant theta. So is that so? Is this entire thing, this one, the one which I'm circling, is equal to cot theta plus cosecant theta? If you somehow prove that, that's done. I think that will be there, but I am leaving it here. Why? Because anyways, let's not get into that. The proof is there. It is, the other one will become little lengthy. So hence, you can always do this. So simplify. This has been purposefully given like that. So hence, can you separate the two out of it or not was the question. Okay. Or if someone has done by sine and cos, that's fine. Never mind. Let's complete our set of questions. And you can always adopt this method. No problem. Chalo, do this. Yes, I will try, Yashika. Let's finish it. And towards the end, we get some time. We will come back to the problem. But, it can be solved that ways as well. No problem. Do this one. Done. Anish says done. This is a fairly simple question, I believe. Oh, yeah. You have to club sine plus cos together, I believe, and then it should be done. So just club this together. So Yashika done, Shreyas done, Aryan done, Monish done. So club these two together. Very good. Good to see lots of people are participating and responding actively. Very good, guys. Again, keep that goal in your sight. What is the goal? What's the goal? Goal has to be in sight always, right? Very good. Keep the goal in mind now. So hence, what did I say? Just club them together. So sine theta plus cos theta plus 1 and sine theta plus cos theta minus 1. You can sense this is a square minus b square form. And there is secant theta into cosecant theta as well. So this is nothing but sine theta plus cos theta whole squared minus 1. Correct? And this is secant theta times cosecant theta. Okay, so expand this. So this is nothing but sine square theta plus cos square theta plus 2 sine theta cos theta minus 1 times secant theta. You can directly write this as well, just for the sake of clarity. Okay. Yep. So hence, so this is this minus 1, that is 0. So this is nothing but 2 times sine theta cos theta by sine theta cos theta is equal to 2, right? So this is 1. So you have to write, since okay. Yashika, what are you saying? So, sir, take the last part, the other side.
Sir, if you take the that secant theta and cosecant theta that side, then you'll get these two multiplied is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta.
I don't need 2. Is it, you know, again, we are following that route, no? That let it be as far as possible from one side. So I don't need to take them actually. So you get, you know, get cancelled in this left hand side itself. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, chalo, next one. Oh, again, radical sign, easy one. You now know what to do. Come on. Jahan, the moment you saw any radical sign, the first thing which should strike you is to come, you know, make it a perfect square somehow. Aditi has done. Okay, Aditi. Monish is also done. Okay, very good. Anish done. Anish. Wow. Rhythmic names. Aditi done. Aryan done. Shobita done. From Surya P to everyone. Sir, is it possible to solve by taking sine theta and 1 plus minus cos theta in the previous? I'm sorry. Previous question. Okay, we'll come back to previous. Surya, just hold on. Monish done. Srijani done. Purav done. Akshita Goyal done. Nee, Akshita is saying Doen. Purav, Yeshika, Aniket, Srishti, Satyam. Dun. Ananya, Pranav. Suya P. Akshita. Sir, typo dot done. SRY. Comma, typo dot done. That's Akshita. Okay. Yes. Others? Dosto? Friends, brothers and sisters of India, what happened? Come on. Everyone's done. Girija done. Very good. Next. Come on. Hoga. Now what to do here? Again. So simply Prisham's done. Very good, Prisham. So secant theta minus 1 divided by secant theta plus 1. So what I'll do is I will multiply this with secant theta minus 1 and root ko thoda lamba karo secant theta minus 1. Right? Plus, if you plus it, you'll get secant theta plus 1 times secant theta plus 1 divided by secant theta minus 1 secant theta plus 1. Very good. That's what they're asking. So it's nothing but upar wala bahar aagya secant theta minus 1 divided by root over secant square theta minus 1. So we'll go one more step. Let's not rush. So secant theta plus 1 divided by root over secant square theta minus 1 again. Isn't it? Okay, my dear friends, so this is nothing but secant theta minus 1. So in the denominator, you will get secant theta minus 1 divided by tan theta plus secant theta plus 1 divided by tan theta, which is equal to. So 2 times secant theta upon tan theta, which is equal to 2 times, you can write if you wish, cos theta into sine theta by cos theta, which is equal to 2 times cosecant theta. Yahan pe bas aap ye likh dijiye ki secant square theta minus 1 is tan. Perfect. Bolo, koi problem? Akshay Rao is also done. So far so good, guys. Any trouble? Next. Now this is again a different way of asking about identity. So secant theta plus tan theta is m. Show that this again is very easy, I believe. Yes, this is a 4 mark, sir. Which one is 4 mark, Monish? This one. So I have removed any, you know, I have removed the possibility of all the, you know, so even if now, if previously it was 4 mark, now it will be either 3 marker or 2 marker. No 4 marker in the upcoming exam. Simply substitute and find. That's it. Aryan Tandon done. Surya P done. / Monish done. Guys, are you writing down or on a piece of paper or are you just doing mentally? Mind mein sab kuch. Very good. Please write. Yashika has done. Very good. Pranav VJ done. Substitute. Done. Another question in which there is secant theta minus tan theta is equal to n. So there will be multiple varieties, Manish. Okay, folks, shall I try or you are going to finish this up? Jaldi. Srijani says done. Ananya says done. Akshita says done. Aditi Bajaj says done. Arundhati says done. Very good. So let me now do it. So ends I will do is this. What I'm going to do is M ko just substitute. Secant theta plus tan theta. Whole square plus 1. Expand. Secant square theta plus tan square theta plus 2 secant theta tan theta minus 1 divided by secant square theta plus tan square theta plus 2 secant theta tan theta plus 1. Correct? No. Now we will use the identities. So secant square theta minus 1 ko club kar do. So what will this be? Secant square theta minus 1 plus tan square theta plus 2 secant theta tan theta, and denominator mein club these two. So you'll get secant square theta plus tan square theta plus 1. Show it like that, and 2 secant theta tan theta. Okay, now here is the beauty. Secant square theta is minus 1 is tan square theta plus tan square theta plus 2 tan theta secant theta divided by secant square theta plus secant square theta plus 2 tan theta secant theta. Okay, now what you can take common, what can we take in common in the numerator? So you can take 2 tan theta common, within brackets it is tan theta plus secant theta. In the denominator you can take 2 secant theta common and secant theta plus tan theta. Okay folks, so this goes, so 2 and 2 goes. So tan theta by this thing is sine by cos into secant theta, which is sine theta. Done. Okay. And I'm not writing the reasonings. Reasonings, you can please mention the reasons there. Hanji, do this one. Oh, this is similar. We did this. Did we do this? No. There was a question similar to this, but not exactly this one, but same only. Yes. Similar only. So that time it was 1 upon cos plus secant, cosecant plus, I think, something like that. Anyways, try it. Or hold on. This is similar. Try this one. Leave that. Try this one. Done. Aniket says done. Done in bad writing. Yeshika also says done. Good, Yeshika. Keep it up. Surya done. Four people done. Writing steps is so annoying. Giving marks without seeing the steps is so annoying. Aniket ji, Gupta ji. Done. Okay. So please write steps. If there are no steps, how will you climb from ground floor to top floor? And how will you get down also? You'll hurt yourself. Steps are important in life. Lift. Good one. If examiner could understand our handwriting, everything would be easy. If examiner, you know, if he gets a power of understanding handwriting, why can't he directly get the power of read your minds? Khatam, enough. So I can read Munish's mind. Yes, he is doing sine theta plus cos theta there. Okay, he's doing right. Full marks to him. Exam correctors are literally like robots. Oh my God, you have different, you know, so much of this thing. You have to revere them till they give you good marks at least. Okay, so don't send wrong vibes. Okay, so they are listening. Anyways, chalo. So cos theta plus sine theta is root 2 cos theta. Show that cos theta. What did you do, guys? I would have done this. Cos theta plus sine theta is equal to root 2 cos theta. That means I can say root 2 times cos theta. Oh, sorry. Squaring both sides and all. Not needed. Waise kar sakte ho waise. I will do like this. What will I do? I will write cos theta common. Root 2 minus 1 is equal to sine theta. Okay, now I will say, let cos theta minus sine theta is equal to x. Okay, and what is given? Cos theta plus sine theta is equal to root 2 cos theta. Add both of them. So you'll get 2 cos theta is equal to root 2 cos theta plus x. So x is equal to 2 cos theta minus root 2 cos theta. Root 2 cos theta common, you will get root 2 minus 1. Isn't it? Yeah. And root 2 minus 1 cos theta is sine theta. So x is root 2 sine theta. Done. So this is, since it is what? Since we know that root 2 minus 1 cos theta is equal to sine theta. Okay, so this is also, you know, you can do either ways which you want. Okay, folks, so this is done. Anyone, any difficulty here? No doubt. Shall we proceed? This is mechanical. Very unlikely, Shreyas, very unlikely that you will get an identity for 5 marks, but because then where will the heights and distance application problem go? Can you solve the last one by squaring both sides? Yes, please do. No problem. You can square and do. No problem. Meghna, to answer your query. Which one? Oh, you want to show, you want me to show you that? So those who are solving this question, please solve. Achha, let me solve that question back after this one by squaring. So let me solve it here itself in this space. So that question was, I believe, cos theta plus sine theta. So square both sides, you will get cos square theta plus sine square theta plus 2 cos theta sine theta barabar 2 cos square theta. Correct? Yes. So now, what will you get? You will get, this implies cos square theta minus sine square theta minus 2 sine theta cos theta. So you take everything on one side is equal to 0. Am I right? Cos ka idhar cos gaya minus sine mein. Yes. Now do what? This implies cos square theta plus sine square theta. Add sine square theta to it. Minus 2 sine theta cos theta. And then on the other side, you will get 2 sine square theta. See? So add 2 sine square theta.
So one second. Shouldn't that be cos square plus sine square?
No. This is 2 cos square, no? So 2 minus this cos. On the other side, I'm writing.
Okay. All right.
Right. So hence 2 cos square theta minus cos square theta will be cos square theta. Then this sine on the other side will become minus sine square. And this plus 2 cos theta sine theta on the other side will become minus 2 sine theta cos theta. And entire thing is 0. Now add 2 sine square theta to both sides. Why? Because I want to complete this square. So now you'll get the desired result. What is that? Sorry. So this is cos theta minus sine theta. Whole square is equal to 2 sine square theta. And hence it will follow. Understood?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Hanji, this one done. Isn't this 5 marks identity sum? No, there is no 5 marks identity. No, they will not give you, but practice kar lo na. What is the problem? Okay, so what is this? This is a mechanical problem. So hence there is no brainer in this. Simply keep doing what? Multiplying. Am I right? Or secant cube minus cosecant cube. Secant cos cube minus sine cube. Okay, so here what will I do? I will convert everything into sine and cos. Dekho. 1 plus, and I am writing only in C and S. Okay, so C by S plus S by C. So you don't do this in the exam. This is just to save space here. Hence. Okay, this is S minus C divided by secant is 1 by C cube minus 1 by S cube. That's it. So this is, take the common denominator SC. This will be SC plus C square plus S square in 1. Here S minus C. And here it is going to be S cube minus C cube into C cube into S cube. I hope all of you are getting it. So I'm just writing in shorthand. I don't have space hence. Otherwise, please do not write in S and C and all that. Or if you are very, you know, you can start only with let cos theta be S, let sine theta be, but that is, please don't do that. You never know. People would not be happy. Okay. Anyways. So what do I do now? So it is SC plus C square plus S square. I can directly write 1. Then S minus C. And then C cube, S cube. Achha, I will just, you know, I will make it C square, S square. Divided by S cube minus, this thing is S minus C. S square plus C square plus SC. So again, this will go, this will go. So C square, S square. Okay. Clear? No problem, Yashika. Now clear, everyone. I just did in very shorthand. So you have to write all that sine, cos and all. Any step you didn't understand? See, again, I just cancelled here this step. Why? Because, wait, where did the pointer go? Yeah. So this is 1 and this is SC. So this and this will go. Any problem, guys? Hello, people. People. Problem, no problem, people. ये करो और एक ये है ए, 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 आ, बस सो ओके दिस वन इज इजी डू दिस वन कुड यू गो बैक व्हाई नॉट हियर दिस वन आदित्य एनी डाउट एनीवेयर प्लीज आस्क Okay, do this one. Is transposition allowed? You can or without that also you can do every time you don't need to start from LHS and go to RHS you can start with a standard identity so here you can start with an identity called cosecant square minus cot square theta is 1 this is that manifestation which we had discussed the other you know in the previous slide So you don't need to even start from the LHS. What I'm saying is, here you start with this cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. No problem, no. Yes. So you have cosecant theta minus cot theta is equal to 1 upon What is it? Cosecant theta plus cot theta. Yes or no? So this one you can do. Now, and what else? So that can be written as cosecant theta minus cot theta. Yeah, you can either start from here and then do what or if I prove this now let us say 1 plus cosecant theta plus cot theta plus 1 upon cosecant theta minus cot theta okay and also you can see this also that 1 upon cosecant theta minus cot theta is going to be how much cosecant theta plus cot theta yes or no both are same right this and this both are same so hence start from here and then do what 1 plus cosecant plus cot can be written as cosecant theta minus cot theta plus 1 by cosecant theta minus cot theta can be written as cosecant theta plus cot theta hence it is 2 cosecant theta that is equal to 2 by sin theta okay hence you can write 1 upon cosecant theta plus cot theta minus 1 upon sin theta is equal to 1 by sin theta minus 1 upon cosecant theta minus cot theta proved So I didn't do any transposition, nothing else. What did I do? I first proved that this is equal to this. And I also proved that this is equal to this. And then I started with adding these two quantity. I got 2 upon sine theta. And then I got that. Okay. Anyone has any other step or any other method in this? Someone did something else. Previous one. Which one, Aditya? This one confused. Okay, people are getting confused. Okay, okay. Both questions I will repeat. So here, dekho, let me delete. अच्छा दिस स्टेप इज क्लियर. अरे कहां गया भाई. इज दिस क्लियर व्हाट एवर इज देयर देयर ऑन द बोर्ड सो फार. यस आदित्य इज दैट ओके. ओके चलो. सो नाउ आफ्टर दैट व्हाट डिड आई डू. एस क्यूब माइनस सी क्यूब. सो लेट the numerator be as it is s minus c c cube s cube. Rationalizing in the 3-mark question didn't get any other word for rationalizing. No problem. Yeah, so here just a minute Monish. Now what do you do s just check here. This sc I had you know struck it down and cancelled this and it has become 2. See there was a power 3 here. Power 3 here, but I cancelled with this SC here. There was a SC in the denominator. Aditya, is that clear? Yep. So that is clear. Then what is left? This is S cube minus C cube. What is the expansion? S minus C. S square plus C square plus SC, no? Now what is S square plus C square? 1. So 1 plus SC and this will go, no? This will go and this S minus C will go. So what is left? C square, S square. Clear now? Yep. Next, this one. So Akshita, what was the issue? Dekho, once again, what did I do? Okay. I did this. I said that cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is 1. Hence, cosecant theta minus cot theta is equal to 1 upon cosecant theta plus cot theta. Is this clear? Similarly, cosecant theta plus cot theta will be equal to 1 upon cosecant theta minus cot theta. Is this clear? Same thing. Now add these two. Add these two. What will you get? In the LHS, if I write this, I can write 1 plus cosecant theta plus cot theta plus 1 upon cosecant theta minus cot theta is equal to 2 cosecant theta. If I add the LHS, I'll get 2 cosecant theta, which is nothing but 2 upon sin theta. Right? Now, this 2 upon sin theta can be written as 1 by sin theta plus 1 by sin theta. Now, you take 1 sin theta on the other side, then let the 1 by sin theta on one side. Right? So, let's take this here. And let's take this part there. So what will you get? 1 upon cosecant theta plus cot theta minus 1 upon sine theta is equal to 1 upon sine theta minus 1 upon cosecant theta minus cot theta. Now you understood? This is what was requirement of the question. Yep. They go. Right now. Yes, exactly same. So, using the manifestations which we talked about, you can prove this. Chalo. So, this question now, anyways, we are short of time. So, I'm just leaving it as, you know, a practice question. It is easy. You can do at home as well. This is how it should be written. Dekho. Wherever required reason is given. Reason. Right? So, always, as I told you, keep some 15-20 minutes towards the end of the exam. And all the there will be one or at max 2 questions, right? So when you come back, write all the appropriate reasons wherever required. And one column, one by one, step by step, make it as clear as possible. Do not jump steps and hence done, right? LHS equal to RHS, hence proof. This is what you have to do in identity. See, this is a question which was asked in the board exam, which we didn't do, but it's there. Okay, in the slides, you can solve them. Fair enough. Understood? Any problem, bolo? Kuch takleef to anyone? If yes, then do discuss with me. I am available on phone or WhatsApp. Please reach out to me. And now we are done with trigonometry. So 12 marks are in your pocket. right before the exam, you can try this in the upcoming pre-board. So just go through the slides, whatever we have discussed, and there is no reason you will not get 12 on 12, at least in trigonometry. Is that clear? Okay, will the PPT already shared? Oh, you please be informed. All the PPTs are shared in the same where all till now, whatever we have conducted, all the PPTs have been shared in PDF form. No, it's there. Navya, here. Deko. In your Learnist, go to comprehensive revision program. Here, all the PPTs are attached to the same live class wala link. So you can see, deko, four attachments are there. No? Attachment. Everywhere attachment is there. So this is mathematics quadratic equation. This is electricity. This is mathematics. Then week two. Yesterday, there was acid base. That is there. Now today, after this class, I will attach my PPT here as well. Okay, so use it. Everything is given which is required for acquiring centum in maths. The PPTs should be good enough. Okay, so we have seen that in the past. You can use them. You can try this exam itself, upcoming PT. Fair enough. I hope the session was useful to all of you. You learned something. It was useful. And again, reiterating, what's our target? Target is to get 100% marks, centum in all subjects as much as possible, right? It's very much possible. You are on right track. Just be cool and calm and composed. Do not panic. You have already done so much of work. You have written so many exams. So there is no reason why you should not be getting centum. Fair enough. With all those words, let me sign off. I think we are going to meet next year only, because on 31st, there is no class. So we will be meeting you on, I think, tomorrow there is a bio class. Then there is no class this year. I will meet you next year only. So wishing everyone here a very, very happy new year, corona free year, great and successful milestone wala year. All of you get lots of sentence so that you can cherish that throughout your year. My best wishes to all of you. Bye-bye, folks. Enjoy and see you again next year. Happy New Year to everyone.